There are so many different factors that go into the results of launching a new course, program, service, or product. And while it is pretty sexy to just read off the final revenue numbers or a really impressive conversion rate, there is so much context within a launch. All of the different moving pieces matter and they all impact the results. So when you're figuring out what worked and what didn't work with a launch, you have to look at the whole picture, which is what we're gonna do in this video today. This past May, I launched my very first course ever. It is a course for copywriters, and with this beta launch where the program was not created, where it had never been launched before, my audience had never heard of it before, we did a $24,000 beta launch with a conversion rate, lead to sale conversion rate of 45%. And like I said, all the other moving pieces matter. So I'm gonna share with you all of the moving pieces that went into this launch to help you understand the success of what happened before, during, and after that really gave us the results that we had with this launch. I'm Brittany McBean, launch strategist, conversion copywriter, and ethical marketer, and I write launch copy for online entrepreneurs selling courses and programs at scale. And today I'm gonna tell you what happened when I launched my very first program for our business. So let's start with the numbers. This course was a program for copywriters looking to build a premium copywriting business. It was a gap that I saw in the market. It was something I wish I had when I was creating my business. And I thought that I could take what I've learned over the past few years, turn around and teach it to people just like me. So we launched it as a beta, which means it was not created fully when it was launched. It was outlined, but not created. The price for the program was severely underpriced. We charged $500. It's definitely a $2,000 program, but for the beta round, that is what felt right for me. Our goal was 5 people. That's all I thought that would join. We ended up with 48 students at the end of a 5-day launch. It was a webinar style launch. The webinar show up rate was 68% of our leads list. Our sales page converted at 15.95%, so 16%. And the lead to sale conversion rate, which means the number of people that actually joined the program, so the number of people that purchased, divided by the number of leads on our leads list, which are the people that I segmented out of the bigger audience to identify as the right person for this program. So the lead to sale conversion was 45.71%. Now, did I catch lightning in a bottle with this launch and it's never gonna happen again? Maybe. And I'll let you know when we launch it for the second time, which is going to be this fall. But even if we caught lightning in a bottle, I will take $24,000 lightning in the bottle any day. So let me walk you through the different things that happened with this launch that I think really contributed to those conversion rates and that revenue. Anytime you are doing any marketing campaign, your order of operations always goes audience, offer, copy. Your audience, your people, your list, whatever you want to call them, is always more important than the offer. They always come first. And the offer, the actual program or product or course that you are selling to your audience, is always more important than the copy. And when I say copy, we'll just use that as the word for all of the messaging and marketing assets that go into a launch. So when you're putting your energy into strategy, you need to think audience, then your offer, and then finally your copy. So let's talk about the audience. So last year I had a couple speaking opportunities in front of copywriter communities and copywriter audiences. And I started noticing that my Instagram following was going up with copywriters. My email list had people opting in and hopping on specifically for the lead magnets geared towards copywriters. My DMs, my emails were all filling up with copywriters. So that meant that I was getting a segment of my audience that was made up of copywriters, not just the course creators that I serve. Up until then, a large majority of the people on my email list had been online entrepreneurs and course creators, whether they were people who were right for a done-for-you one-on-one service, or if they just wanted to follow me to learn a little bit more about launching an online course. That was who was on my list before these speaking opportunities. But I noticed that clearly something I was saying was resonating with other copywriters because they were jumping in my world. Seth Godin brilliantly said, don't find customers for your product, find products for your customers. And what that simply meant, that's the same thing as audience and offer. That means that rather than deciding what you're going to sell and then finding the leads for that product, you look at the people that you already have in front of you who are wanting to learn from you, and you ask yourself, what is it that they need? What can I do better than anyone else? What gap in the market can I fill? That's what she said. How can I serve these people? Why are they on my list? So that's what I did. When I was starting to build my copywriting business, I knew that I wanted to create a premium copywriting business. I wanted to offer a high-end service for high-end prices for high-end clients. Even though we are super casual and low-key around here, I still wanted to provide an excellent experience and an excellent product. So I set out to build a premium copywriting business, although I had no idea what that even meant. I had never been in a corporate world before. I had never been in a service industry. I've worked in hospitality and served tables, but not as a service provider. I have never been in the business world, and I was looking everywhere for someone to teach me how to start a service-based business, specifically one geared towards premium clients. Honestly, I stalked as many people as I could. I grabbed as much information as I could, and then I just faked it till I made it. I made it up on the fly, on the job training, and I created a business that has done that, that has served high-level clients at premium prices with an absolute premium product. And I thought I could take what I learned, turn back around and teach that to other copywriters looking to do the same thing and not knowing how. So we'll talk about the offer in a minute, but let's keep talking about the audience. So once I knew that this was a course, program, piece of educational content that I wanted to create, I started getting really intentional about how I talked about my business and sharing about it. So no, the program wasn't created yet. I didn't have a name for it. I didn't even know when I was launching it, but I knew that this is something that me, the business, and my team were going to be working on in the future. It was a goal. So every time I got on a podcast or spoke in a mastermind or spoke in any sort of visibility opportunity where any copywriter could possibly be listening at some point, I mentioned something about the processes and systems behind my business, how we serve premium level clients, how I have built a business that can consistently command five-figure rates. Every contract we set out is a five-figure contract, almost every contract. And I talked about what that looked like to create that business. Even if I wasn't getting into detail, I was planting that seed of, this is something I've intentionally done. I've done it through systems and processes, and this has been the result. So I was mentioning that everywhere I spoke to try to begin to create that awareness around what it is that I've done intentionally so that the other people who want to do that too will kind of start to perk their ears up so they could pick up what I was dropping. This past spring, I was invited to speak at a large event that was total bucket list goals for me. And it was an event that would host a lot of copywriters. The Copywriter Club is a community formed by Kira Hug and Rob Marsh. They have a podcast. They are people I have admired, have looked up to for mentorship for a long time. I'm in their mastermind, and they invited me to speak on their stage at TCC IRL, which stands for the Copywriter Club in real life. Only this year it was TCC not IRL because it was on Zoom because of the pandemic. But I still knew that this was a massive opportunity to stand in front of other copywriters like myself who are currently where I was 6 months, a year, 2 years ago, and start to position myself as an authority in my business, even though my topic had nothing to do with creating a premium copywriting business. I was able to still see that within my presentation and provide an opt-in at the end to gather those names of people who might be interested in learning from me as a copywriter. So that was a way, that was my kind of big authority building way of building my leads list. And I knew that the best way to leverage that opportunity was to get this course out within 30 days of that speaking opportunity, because people are always the most excited to learn from you and buy from you and all of those things when they first met you. So I didn't want to let a lot of time go by between that event and when I launched this course. So when I got invited to speak at this event, we quickly put the launch on the calendar within 30 days, made a launch plan, and we decided to just go all in. So that is how I built the audience. And more importantly, I looked at the audience that was already there and said, what is it that they need? Now we started to build out the actual offer because the audience was there. So we had to figure out what it is that they would want, need, and buy. So for the offer, I knew that we were going to position this as a beta version from day one. I was not going to pretend like this was a super sexy built out offer, one that we had done before, one that was already complete. I knew that it was going to be a beta. So instead of creating this entire program based out of absolutely nothing but thin air, I decided that I would do all the research I needed to understand what this specific person person, the person who is perfect for this program, is wanting or needing, and then to create the outline based on that. So after doing extensive research, listening to the person, the type of person that I thought was perfect for this program, I got pretty clear on what they were asking for, what they were wanting, what they were needing, the outcome they were looking for, what that solution provided for them, whether it was templates or calculators, all of those things. And then I created the outline that I truly believed would lead to the transformation I was promising based on the experience that I had. So I took what they were saying they were wanting and needing, the information that I knew that I wanted to teach, and I kind of mashed it together into one super offer. And I put that on the sales page. So on the sales page, I listed key deliverables that I knew I was going to be providing, whether they were swipes or templates or trainings. These were the ones that I knew were foundational and essential to, one, getting someone's buy-in on the program, but two, delivering that transformation, but also leaving a ton of room for additional content to be created based on what was happening in the room as we taught the program. I made sure to optimize the program by adding in those resources that really signaled to people that this was going to be the content that helped them get where they want to be. This wasn't just another high-level strategy, no way to implement, non-actionable course, that this was something that they could literally take, plug into their business, and achieve success immediately. So I optimized it using all of the things that I thought would really communicate that to the student. I also added in audits and live Q&As. That was not something I was intending to do on future offers, but I thought if I can stand in front of them weekly and answer questions in real time that they're asking, then I can really start to understand what kind of content is clicking with them, where the gaps are, what they are missing, what needs further clarification, and just what they're struggling with overall. So that really, really helped me continue to create content and to continue to create the offer even after it was sold. And then the audits, I thought, was a really great way of communicating to them that being a part of this beta group means you get my eyes on stuff that future cohorts will not. It also was my way of doing research to make sure that I can make this program the best it possibly could be. So by providing those audits where I got to critique their work, give them feedback on their work specifically to the scope of this program, and the live Q&As, I was really able to keep my finger on the pulse, understand what was going on with them, and continue to create the offer in real time that delivered the transformation promised. And last but not least, I way underpriced it. I priced it at least a third, if not a fourth, of what its ultimate price will be. It might even end up being higher than $2,000, depending on what this program turns out to be. But I knew that if I priced it at $500, it would be a no-brainer for these students. Okay, audience, offer. Now we get to talk about copy. And again, when I say copy, let's just assume that that means overall strategy, messaging, and copy. So I started creating some pre-launch content. And when I say pre-launch content, what I mean is the type of content that is hyper-related to this course content to really call out the right student for this program. Because I knew, again, I had people on my list that were interested in launching their own courses, that were following me for copywriting advice, that were not necessarily copywriters building a copywriting business. So if I put out pre-launch content that really was the bat signal for the copywriter looking to build a premium copywriting business, then they would be able to raise their hand, pick up what I'm dropping, and call themselves out, step forward out of the crowd to segment themselves as the right person for this program. So I was creating pre-launch content to put up that bat signal and to segment them out. And so I had links on my in my emails that when they clicked on it, it would tag them. I had freebies that really specifically spoke to this person that either brought them into my audience or tagged them as that person so that I could segment them out. So I wasn't sending launch emails to a course creator who had no interest in creating a copywriting business. So the first thing that I did was segment them, call them out, put that bat signal in the pre-launch content. Secondly, in my messaging, in my strategy, in my efforts, I could not have set the bar any lower. There was no smoke and mirrors here. I was not trying to pretend like this was a fancy show and a fancy launch, and that even though I'm teaching them how to write a copywriting business, we're not doing anything special over here. The bar was low. Let me tell you what I mean. What I mean is that in all of the copy, I was 100% transparent. Hey, I haven't created this content before. I'm actually not really sure what it's going to be. I know what I want to teach you and what I'm going to give you, and I need you to show up and tell me what it is that you need for this transformation. And if you're not going to show up and give me feedback, if you're not okay with the shitty first draft of this program, then wait. If this is the content you need, but you want to wait until it's $1,500, $2,000, and it's ready to go and everything you need, then totally wait. You have my blessing. That is fine. But if you're good with the shitty first draft, come on board. And when I say the bar could not have been any lower, you all, I did the webinar. I let them know, hey, I wasn't even going to do this webinar last week, and then I randomly decided to do it, and here we are. And as I was going through the webinar, there were typos that I thought I had caught, and I just called them out. I just said, you know what? I created this in a frenzy and I was really excited to get you this, and there are typos and it's okay. It's not a big deal. And if that's the reason you don't want to join this program is because you need perfection, well then I'm not the person for you, because I'm never going to give you perfection. In one of the slides in the webinar, there was still a placeholder for an image on the slide that pitched the program. There was the Canva image with the blue sky and the green grass in place of where a picture of the course content, the program, should have been. I was fine with it. We laughed about it on the webinar. I had people who bought just because of that slide, and I said, this is what you should be expecting. The bar is low. We keep it super casual around here. We don't try to be perfect. This is what you're signing up for. And people were really, really into that. I also let them know, hey, there's no poor tax on this. I didn't add a percentage for the investment if they wanted to do multiple payments. We had a one pay and a two pay plan, and I just said there's no poor tax. You can pay $500, you can pay $250. You pick the plan that is right for you. And I think we had 28 people choose the payment plan. Nobody defaulted on the payment plan. Nobody asked for a refund. I let them know how much of this content was created, how much I was bringing to the table, how much time and energy and effort that I was committing to giving them, while asking for their co-collaboration with this. I was 100% transparent about what joining this cohort meant. I was also very, very, very clear about exactly who this program was for and exactly who it was not for. We had a ton of support requests in our inbox, which also let me know what I need to clarify on the sales page moving forward. But of people asking, I'm just beginning, is this right for me? And we were able to confidently say, if you have never served a copywriting client before, this information is not going to be applicable to you now. It will be later. And if you choose to jump in at this price, then yes, you'll be able to use this later. But this is not necessarily meant for you. This is meant for someone who has an established business, who has worked with clients before and is now trying to figure out how to go from that overwhelm, hustle, no systems, disorganization, just total overcapacity with their clients, to sending out consistent five-figure contracts, getting them signed, working in a place of calm, coolness, and clarity with clients, with a premium copywriting service at a premium price with premium clients. That's who this is for. And so we were able to let people know, no, this isn't right for you. And yes, this is right for you. Come on in. And by doing that, again, we lowered the return rate. We lowered the support request. We lowered the default on payments. We had zero default, zero refunds. And all of that is because we were crystal clear about who this was for, who it was not for. I also didn't create any fake urgency or scarcity. I let people know, hey, the card is closing on this day. It was a 5-day card open. I said, the card is closing on Friday. If you want to get in this program before the card closes, that is your deadline. I just want you to know that. If you want to wait, we are launching again in September. It will be $1,500 to $2,000. So you can save up that money. You can plan for it around that time. It wasn't this, I don't know when we'll be launching it again. The price will never be this low. We just let them know all of the facts to empower the student, the reader reading it, to give them full agency to make a confident decision. And I think that really allowed the people who knew that this was the right time for them to jump in. And hopefully it's allowed some people to wait until the more complete and robust offer is created at a higher price point. The other thing that I did in my copy, which is something I do in pretty much everything that I write and sell, is I made sure that my values were front and center. The values that technically had nothing to do with this content, but have everything to do with how I create a business. I let people know that our business believes that Black Lives Matter. Our business believes in including and providing space and safety for historically and systemically marginalized people, Black and Brown people, people in the LGBTQ plus community, people who traditionally have not had a lot of safety and space provided for them in this world, in the online entrepreneur world. That is something we are committed to. That is a non-negotiable and a zero tolerance policy. So if you don't align with those values, you are not welcome in this community, because being inclusive means providing a safe space for the people that need to be included, that need to be safe, and not allowing in the people that jeopardize the safety of that community. And so because we were committed to that, I made sure that was all over the page, which meant that the people who don't believe that Black Lives Matter, who don't believe that inclusion and equity is of a foundational importance in the work that we do, they didn't buy. And the people who needed to hear that message, who needed to know that this was a safe space and that we were actively doing work to make it a safe space, that I wasn't just saying that, they knew that maybe this was going to be a little bit different. Maybe this is a place where they could come in, kind of let their freak flag fly, not because they're freaks, but because we're all freaks and we all need to show up as our full authentic self, and they could get the mentorship, the guidance, the community that they need. I will always stand behind putting my values all over everything. I am fine if that means people do not buy. It is actually my preference, because the reality is we use our business to give back to other communities. We use our business to support historically and systemically marginalized people. So if you are paying me, that's where your money is going. So if you don't want your money going there, then don't give me your money. That's just how it goes. And if you do, well, then let's all make the world better by doing better, right? So even though that had nothing to do with the program I was selling, that is something that I made sure was a neon sign on every single thing that we wrote for this launch. So over a 2-week period of time, I sent out webinar invite emails. Then I sent out show up emails for the people who registered for the webinar. And then I sent out launch emails for all of the people that registered for the webinar, my leads list. I think we sent out between 20 and 25 emails between all of those sequences. So webinar, show up, and launch. So cart opened, a cart closed. And then we also had a series of onboarding sequences after that. The cart was open for 5 days. We had 28 people buy in the first 24 hours, and we had 9 people buy on the last day. So everybody else came in between those 5 days with a total of 48 students. Again, that was a 45% lead to sale conversion rate. Our sales page converted at 16%, and we have had 0 refunds and 0 defaults on payments while making $24,000 within those 5 days for our very first program that wasn't even created yet. Has creating the work been a challenge? Absolutely. It is a lot of work to create a course. I am actively in the middle of teaching that program now. I'm creating the content now. It is taking a ton of time. It is so much more than I thought it would be. The students are really, really challenging me and pushing me, and I love every second of it. And I know that when we launch it again in September, it is going to be 10 times better than the original version, which makes me feel really confident in raising the price. So there's the context, the breakdown, the strategy, the audience, the offer, and the copy behind our $24,000 beta launch, the very first launch that we ever did as a business. If there's anything I didn't cover, if you have any questions about beta launching, launching in general, creating a course, or building a premium copywriting business, leave them in the comments below and I'll make sure to either answer you there or create another video answering your question in more detail. If you made it this far, thank you for watching all the way to the end. Make sure to hit that thumbs up button and go ahead and subscribe so that you are catching the new videos when they drop every single week. All right, I'll see you next time.